Hello everyone, this is Cory with the Yosemite Conservancy. We fund research, restoration, and other park projects. And I'm coming to you today from beautiful Yosemite National Park. And as you can see, we just received quite a bit of snowfall from our recent storm, a couple feet of snow throughout the park. And we're all adapting to this new winter weather that we're seeing. And it got me thinking about how other species here in Yosemite are adapting. You know, many of our bears are starting to den for the winter to endure these long, cold winter nights. You know, other bird species are flying south to warmer weather, and some species are adapting here. And specifically, one of those species, the Clark's Nutcracker. The Clark's Nutcracker is a bird that is located in the high elevations here in the park in the subalpine region. The Clark's Nutcracker is part of the corvid family, so crows and jays and magpies. And it really has a unique adaptation to surviving these long winter months. And what it does is it collects food all throughout the summer. Specifically, it collects seeds from our whitebark pine species here in the park. And it'll disperse these seeds in caches throughout an area of several miles. And it might cache 20 or 30,000 different areas to store seeds. And with that amount of seeds that it's storing, we have to wonder, well, how can it remember where all these caches are? And the way that it does that is that it actually swells its brain to remember where these food caches are. It's called hippocampus plasticity. And what it'll do is as it stores these seeds, it'll store that information in its brain, and as that information grows, so does its brain. It starts to swell out, remembering where all of these food caches are. And the Clark's Nutcracker can remember about 90% of its food caches. It has this amazing memory. So it'll remember where all these areas are, it'll swell its brain out, holding all that information, and then as winter goes on, it'll dig through the snow, find its caches, eat its food, and with that, its brain will start to shrink down, releasing that brain power. So its brain grows and shrinks throughout the years. Pretty amazing. You could imagine what we could do with that type of brain power. You know, we'd always remember where we put our cell phones, we would never lose our car keys. It's really astounding. So how are you adapting to the winter? Are you creating food caches in your house? Are you loading up on new books that you want to read? How are you adapting to the winter?